Pressure is a privilege. We take it head on.
It's always fun to win, especially those championships.
Sometimes we'll go hunt or go shoot some stuff, but pretty much all you have to do is play basketball.
Just working our tails off to get better every day, and at the end of the year, that's when the championships come.
Our name's always going to be remembered and as one of the best, you know, dynasties and schools in 1A of all time.
Through our basketball, we want people to know where Crane is.
The smaller the town, the bigger the game. Crane didn't come up with the phrase, but they sure could have.
It's the only show in town, right? I mean, it's the front page, it's the back page, it's the sports page.
It was just 2 years ago that tiny Crane High School was trying to capture its first ever boys basketball state title in school history.
On the right wing, over to Nichols, the sophomore lines it up at the horn, and he buries it! And he buries it! Carter Nichols buried the three to end the ball game.
The high school had been in existence for 101 years, but there'd never been a championship banner raised to the rafters.
It's been quite a while, never won one here.
The Mustangs went on a Hoosiers-esque run, winning state and making school history.
We broke a 101-year drought.
In 2023, they did it again. Back-to-back state champs.
The pressure of championship number two was huge in that back-to-back.
And earlier this month, they made it three in a row.
These guys went down in history, and they're going to go down in history as one of the best small school basketball teams ever.
Three Oregon State 1A titles in a row, something no 1A team had ever done. History made again, this time statewide.
Win three in a row, something nobody's done before in 1A.
It's incredible.
Put the work in ever since you were little, and it's just nice to see it pay off, you know.
Basically everybody from Crane was there. The gym was packed every game, and just, it was surreal.
The Mustangs went from Cinderella to dynasty in just three seasons. But even as things change, things stay the same. The school threw yet another pep rally to celebrate the title.
These gentlemen have done something that has never been done in an Oregon small school. Three in a row. Three state championships in a row.
The K through 12 country kids from Crane got down again. The Sheriff's Department supplied a police escort from Burns to Crane again. And the Crane community came out to support their team, their kids, their school again. Tri-tip and all.
The community's been, you know, everything. Like I told the guys in the locker room after the game, you guys are the best teammates, the best coaches, this is the best community I'll ever be a part of.
It's full of amazing people. Every day seeing these people, it's just, they're really nice, kind, and they care about you. So that's what we're about here.
I said it before, And I'll say it again, the Hoosiers, they got the movie, but the Mustangs, they got the titles. Back to back to back. And they'll go for a fourth next year.
Sharing those moments with these special, special kids, pinch me and hope you don't wake up a little bit.
You'd be hard pressed to find a town smaller. And I'd venture to say you'd be even more hard-pressed to find a game bigger.
Playing with my best friends is really a dream come true.
Every time you come out here, you see everybody every single time, and they're cheering hard.
It was just really special.
I love all those kids and I love all those moments, and I'm not gonna forget any single one of them.
In Crane, Eric Lindstrom, Central Oregon Daily News.